A pop culture icon, a male feminist, and two amazing women. Welcome to the Double X Agenda. Hey, so there are a couple of things that have caught the eye of the Double X Agenda in the past 1 month. Yani, amazing, amazing stuff. So the first thing is Drake. Roll on, I know shorty and she doesn't want no slow song. Had a man last year, life goes on. Haven't let the thing loose, girl, in so long. You been inside, know you like to lay low. I've been peeping what you bringing to the table. Working hard, girl, everything paid for. First, last phone. Woo, so I'm so feeling that song. I really am. It's a song that, okay, let me just say. I'm not a hip-hop head. I really am not. I will occasionally play the one hip-hop jam here and there. But the reason I'm feeling this song is because I feel like it's a political song. Yeah, let me explain. So Drake is a pop culture icon. A pop culture icon is the kind of person who can post a song and within a month, like this song, get 100 views. As of shooting today, it actually has 100 million views on YouTube. A pop culture icon is a person who can influence how you dress, what you do, where you go, what scent you buy, what food you eat, and so many other things. They've got a lot of influence. So I feel that for the longest time ever, women have been told to be nice. And nice just means sit there, just be nice and proper. I remember many years back when I was in class 2, my dad was called by my teacher because I was being overly talkative and I was very vocal in class. And thankfully, I have a very liberal dad who was like, that is a whole load of biscuits. So he didn't do anything about it and he just thought, okay, why is she calling me? Because my daughter is being too vocal. And what the teacher then said is that she needs to be nice and proper and just chill. And I feel because of those boxes and that straitjacket that many people tell women to be nice, it's restrictive. And this song says, nice for what? I feel it's a female empowerment conversation. And by the way, I might be extrapolating this song a little bit too much, but that's what I feel and that's why I really like it. And not only does Drake say, nice for what? The song was actually directed by a 22-year-old woman. The song features amazing, empowered black women who are doing amazing stuff like Yara Shahidi, like Zoe Saldana, Tiffany Haddish, Tracy Ellis Ross, and so many others. Plus, the song also samples iconic X Factor by Lauryn Hill. So I feel like it's a statement he's trying to make. I just wish people in the hip-hop genre, because it's known to be a very misogynistic space, were able to do much, much more with their influence so that they can empower women more and not objectify them. So think about it, nice for what? All right, so number two. The second thing that really, really jazzed us here at the Double X Agenda this past month is a CNN documentary about a guy who was imprisoned in a prison in California. And this guy is only 25 years old. He is in for a couple of years, I think, for armed robbery. And he's a male feminist. Yeah, like just take a moment to just let that sink in. He's a male feminist, not only by word, but by deed as well. So let me tell you what this guy is doing. This guy behind bars began to read a lot of books. Then he's now teaching men behind bars, black men behind bars, on femininity. No, not femininity, on feminism, yes. On toxic masculinity and on vulnerability and courage. Like, how awesome is that?
Toxic masculinity, what does that mean?
Boys don't cry.
Boys are tough.
That nigga's a faggot.
That's for punks, that's for sissies.
If you keep crying, I'm gonna give you something to cry for.
It can be dangerous to be a feminist in prison. We all had these great dreams and stuff when we were little kids, but at some point it was more important for us to be tough. It was more important for us to not back down.
I want the power that comes with vulnerability. But I love being a man at the same time.
Many times we tell ourselves, in order for me to survive, I have to be a man.
You stepped on my ego, I'm feeling some type of way, pow!
Mama loves you. That shit didn't mean nothing when I went to school.
People gotta hear me, like you can't just lock me up in here and I don't matter for the next 8.5 years.
And a lot of them come out even worse than they were before.
We cannot challenge our harmful behavior without challenging patriarchy.
On a real note, how you guys expect me to do that?
Orange jumper, oversized, tears fill my parents' eyes. Judge gave me 40 life, 40 days, 40 night. Pray the passions.
We don't gotta live like this, y'all.
Give me life. When we get on these streets, hunt me every night. The circumstances are different.
Will we react the same then?
We're a part of a movement.
The whole part of existing in this world has nothing to do with being a man. Has everything to do with being human.
I told you. I really told you. This thing is, it's powerful. It's really, really powerful. If you haven't watched it, I'm going to link the video below. Look for it. It's actually titled The Feminist on Cell Block Y. All right. So the third and final thing that I am absolutely loving, and we are loving here at the Double X Agenda, is a conversation that Chimamanda Adichie Ngozi, no, it's Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie, and Hillary Clinton had this past month. This conversation was awesome on so many levels because these are two women who I love and I look up to. But there's something that came up in the conversation that made me start to think. So at some point, Chimamanda tells Hillary that she's a bit disappointed and upset because Hillary's Twitter bio, get this, begins with mom and then grandma and then wife and then other things like Secretary of State, Democratic nominee. And what Chimamanda said is that I feel like you're a cop-out in a sense. Why would you start with these domestic titles? And if we even look at your husband's Twitter bio, there's no husband, there's no even father in his bio. It's just all the amazing things he's done, including being president of the United States at some point. And it got me really thinking, it really did, because I loved Hillary's response, because she said, you know what, why should it be either or? The women who feel inclined to introduce themselves by their professional achievements, power to you. The women who feel more inclined to introduce themselves by their domestic, in quotes, achievements or status, like mother or wife, then power to you. And it's interesting because Hillary said that she was going to change the bio, and she actually has. So now it doesn't begin with wife or mom or any of that stuff. But I think the question I'd like to ask you and the conversation that I'd like to start is, who do you say you are? Like, really? Like, if somebody meets you in a social gathering, a party, in church, at work, if somebody asks you, who are you? What will you start with? Will it be your professional accomplishments? Will it be your personal and relational accomplishments? I'd really like to know, because I really don't know what my answer would be. I'd like to know what you would think. So please leave your comment on the comment section below. Also, please like this video. And while you're at it, please subscribe. And let's continue talking. Bye.